One of the questions we often get at Old North is whether we have communion silver from Paul Revere. You might think so, given our long association with Paul Revere, first as a bell ringer and then with the lantern shining from the steeple. We do not, however, have Revere silver, as many churches in the Boston area and New England do. We do have special silver, though, and these pieces are an excellent representation of what we have. These were gifted to Old North Christ Church in the city of Boston, as we're formerly known, in 1733, so before Paul Revere became famous, and they were a gift of His Majesty King George II. How we came about them is an interesting and intriguing story. In 1730, Massachusetts received a new governor from the king. His name was Jonathan Belcher. And when he arrived in Boston as governor, he brought with him gifts to King's Chapel, which was the first Church of England parish in Boston. When the leadership at Christ Church learned of the gifts from the king, they thought that they deserved gifts from the king as well. And so they began a letter-writing campaign to the Bishop of London, as well as to political leaders, to acquire gifts of support from the king. Initially, those requests didn't go very well. But in 1731, on March 25th, Governor Belcher declared a day of fasting in Massachusetts. Well, that might not mean a whole lot to you, but to them, that was a significant date. In the Church of England, that was a significant date because that was called Lady Day, also known as the Feast of the Annunciation, when the angel Gabriel announced to Mary that Jesus would be born. It's 9 months exactly before Christmas. So the Anglican leadership in New England was upset that the governor had taken what to them is a feast day and made it a fast day. And so the leadership of Christ Church, as well as the leadership of King's Chapel, went to the governor to plead their case and to complain a bit. Well, Timothy Cutler, our rector at Christ Church, as well as the lay leadership, were apparently very respectful and understood the governor's position. He claimed that as a Puritan, he wasn't aware of the feast day in the Anglican Church. Our friends from King's Chapel were more upset and said that he was trying to undermine the Anglican faith in Massachusetts. And so he became upset with them and became enamored with Timothy Cutler and the leadership at Christ Church. And so thereupon, he began to lobby to the king on behalf of Christ Church so that we too could receive these special gifts. Now in England, they were concerned that every new parish would then want gifts like silver and other furnishings. The governor, however, said, no, we think that two Church of England parishes in Boston will be certainly enough. We won't need more than that. And so they assured England that there wouldn't need to be more gifts coming, but that it would be important to support this church in its infancy. And so in 1733, we received a number of special gifts, the silver, as well as gifts of fabric. So for example, our altar covering today, this is not the original covering, but we received an altar covering of crimson damask, as well as other furnishings of the same color. There would have been a curtain behind me that was also of crimson damask, and kneeler cushions. We also received a wonderful King's Royal Bible with the king's arms written on the inside, as well as several prayer books. And so all of these were called the King's Bounty and were received by Christ Church as a gift of support for this new church growing in Boston. As a result of these gifts, the church, in its appreciation for the governor's work on its behalf, set aside the governor's pew in the front row. And so until then, there hadn't been a governor's pew at Christ Church, but in recognition of his support for us, they dedicated that pew in his honor, and two of the prayer books that were gifted by the king were then placed in that pew. So these communion pieces, these pieces of silver, what we have here is a flagon, and that would have been filled with wine for communion, as well as a chalice that people would have received the communion wine from. And then here we have a paten, which is the plate that the bread would have been served on. And on each piece, we have the same engraving. There's the arms of the royal arms of the king, and then the text, which says, "The gift of His Majesty King George II to Christ Church at Boston in New England at the request of His Excellency Governor Belcher." These pieces were used for communion from the time of the gift in 1733 until well into the 20th century, the early 20th century. They were housed sometimes in the church, sometimes one of the wardens, the lay leaders of the church, kept them at home for safekeeping. At the time of the Revolution, these could have been in peril. King's Chapel silver when the British evacuated Boston, King's Chapel silver was brought back to England, whereas ours was hidden by the lay leaders in the church so that the minister or others who fled Boston couldn't take the silver with them. They were hid either in the basement of the church or in the basement of one of the warden's houses. It's a little unclear, but they were hidden in a basement. Well until the 20th century, they were used as the regular communion silver. However, later in time, it was deemed important to keep them under safer keeping, and so now they are kept off-site at the Museum of Fine Arts in their vault, and we bring them here for our use for special occasions.